Well, I don't often do this, but I have some beer that I need to try on camera because a certain gent was nice enough to send it to me. So, I felt it would only be sporting to be nice enough to drink it. So I'm going to have a go at this Golden Stag, sent to me by Beer Lover 1983 Brew. Thank you very much indeed, my friend. And this is the Golden Stag at 4.5% ABV. And if I'm not mistaken, this is a London Pride. Fuller's London Pride bottle. I've got one of these myself. Okay. We'll get to that in just a second. I'm also going to be incorporating a couple of beers that Ben sent me. The Sierra Nevada one, the IPA, and also the Tet 9 Tiger. See? Ah, you didn't think I was going to be able to remember that there, did you? But I did. I did. Oh, I took the old batteries out of Homer here, so he's not going to make a sound this time. We can listen out for the hiss. There we go. Malt beverages. Right. Let's give it a pour. Oh yeah. Look at that. In the Bell End Brewery tankard. A single thick finger head. Yeah, that smells nice. Me being the, you know, professional beer reviewer that I am, that smells nice, that does. Smells like beer. Oh, you might notice, look. I bit my lip earlier. What a tit. So now, I've had to make this video, look, with a bleeding lip. Well, whatever. It's got a familiar smell about it. Let's see if I can place it. It smells a bit like my ESVA. Extra strong vintage ale that I made with a Cooper's Australian Pale Ale kit and a real ale kit. Various hops and some golden syrup as well. Smell a bit like that. Anyway, enough of this banter. Let's get ripped into this. Thank you very much again. Beer Lover 1983 Brew. Cheers. You've added hops to that for definite. I think it's Golding's hops. I could be wrong about that. I think it's Golding's. You didn't tell me, I promise. Yeah, well, that's good beer. Thank you very much. I really like that, yeah. One thing I wasn't sure about was, are these kit enhancement beers? Are they all grain beers? Are they extract beers? I don't think you actually mentioned, or I'll need to go and check my email again. I don't think you did. Good beer nonetheless. Quality. You know, in certain countries, it's considered rude if you don't burp after drinking or eating someone's food or drink. Oh, that was foamy. Right, let's have a look at the Tet 9 Tiger footage first of all, followed by the IPA footage. Boom. Greetings to Brewmaster Ben. This is the third video of a beer that Ben sent me, and here we have the Tetnang Tiger. Heard good things about it. Darren from Hanworth Homebrew really liked it. Who else got sent some? I don't remember. I got sent some. That's the important thing. And here it is. It is 4.6% ABV, bottled on the 30th of January. So, there we go. Without further ado, I'm going to give it a bash. I really have to change the battery. Oh, some good carb. Mm-hmm. Oh, Gordon Bennett's plenty ahead. Ben gives good head. Yes, he does. So there we are. The Tetnang Tiger. Brutal, look at the head on that, yeah. It's a two finger, in fact, it's over two finger. It's two and a bit finger. I can detect the Tetnang. I want you to all note I'm managing to do this without getting any foam on the end of my nose. Famous last words, eh? Right. Well, without further ado, I'm thirsty, as you can see. I'm a little flushed because I've been bottling beer tonight. So I'm looking forward to this. Let's do it. Thank you very much, Ben. Cheers. That's a good beer. Asked whether it tastes like tiger. I'm assuming it's meant to taste like tiger. I don't know, to be honest. I haven't tasted a bottle of tiger for quite a while. I was going to get a bottle of tiger and do a simultaneous taste test, but that was a couple of weeks ago that I was going to pick up that bottle of tiger, and as the wife pointed out, if I picked it up then, I would have drank it then. So still wouldn't have had a bottle of tiger to test it against, but that's a decent brew. Excellente, my friend. Thank you very much for sending it to me. It's the Sierra IPA. 4.1% ABV. Bottled on the 3rd of this month. Oh, big, nice big bottle. It's pretty clear. Let it settle, it's been kept pretty cold. Yeah. So, we'll leave that on just now. Here's my Skew Home Brew, Bell End Brewery tankard. Now, Homer's going to start going because he's needing his batteries changed. Just telling you now. Right, thank you very much, Ben, for sending me this and the other ones. You'll see me drinking the other ones as well. And we'll find out how well you've done with those ones, laddie. But this one, I'm going to try right now. Oh, Homer, shut up. Listen for the hiss. Oh, that's a good hiss. Homer's busy grumbling again. Oh yeah. Malty. Yep. Let's do this. Gentle pour. Oh, she's carved. She is carved. Oh, we'll leave it there. I don't want to spill over. Quite a bit left in the bottle though, it's a 660. Oh, now, that's nice and clear. Look at this. See that? Carbonated, good head on it. Two finger head. Smell my fingers. Right. Now, there's a familiar smell to it, because I think it's the same yeast in Torpedo as it might be in the Sierra Nevada Pale Ale that Ben used, that he harvested from. I think it is, anyway. I've put mine into a Scotch Ale, just a small brew, 10 litres. On the QT, it's come out tasting bloody excellent, and dry hopping up the stairs just now. But thank you very much, Ben, for this. I really appreciate it, mate. I'm glad it arrived here in one piece. Sorry, Glenn. I get to taste it and you don't, mate. Right, let's go for it. Yeah. I can taste there is a bitterness to it, definitely. Kind of a, I'm not sure how to describe it, like a, very mild, almost grapefruity bitterness to it. Just kind of, not, I'm not saying it's, you know, it's not unpleasant, I really like it, but that's what I'm thinking with the bitterness. I can see why you're not sure about it, Ben, because the bitterness that's in it, it does seem to have this kind of about it, but it's not unpleasant. I don't think that's an unpleasant beer. I think that's a nice beer, definitely. It's a winner for me. I think, if anything, if you're not sure about it, and that kind of bitter flavour to it, which obviously it's a beer, it's going to have bitter to it, maybe a bit more conditioning. Here's me talking about conditioning, and I'm the one that drinking stuff almost as soon as it's carbonated. It's a successful beer, mate. Thank you again for sending it to me. Cheers.